We are in desperate need of a green energy future. I mean, to be honest, at this point, we really need a green energy present, but at this point, I'll take what I can get. And a green energy future is gonna need a lot of things, but one of them is batteries. But batteries kinda suck. They need lots of rare resources to make, they don't last for all that long, and it's just too hard to make enough of them to store all the juice we need. But it turns out that one of the most promising solutions to this battery problem is both incredibly simple and extremely cool. We are going to make batteries with skyscrapers. Now, before we get to how a skyscraper could be a battery, let's talk about why batteries are so vital. The gist is that pretty much every kind of green energy solution we've come up with has the same major drawback, which is that the amount of energy you can make at any given time fluctuates. You're gonna make a lot more solar power on a sunny day than a cloudy one, and a lot more wind power on a windy day than a still one. But we need that power all of the time, not just when it's windy or sunny. And peak demand doesn't always match up with peak output. So we need ways to store up that energy on the good days and release it on demand for the less good days. We could use the batteries we have now, but like I said, they suck. Most common batteries right now are lithium-ion batteries, which require a whole bunch of non-renewable resources that can be environmentally destructive and exploitative to acquire. On top of that, they're also expensive, and they get less efficient with age. Anyone who's had a phone more than a year knows how much worse the battery gets at holding a charge after a while of charge drain repeat. So if the goal is both to be green and to make the world better for everyone in the process, lithium isn't the way to go. We need to find an alternative. And to find one, we're going to have to look somewhere completely different. Allow me to introduce you to the gravity battery. Gravity battery. Gravity battery. And the way they work is right there in the name. It's a battery that uses gravity to store energy. More specifically, gravity batteries work by harnessing potential energy, which you might remember from your physics class. When I lift up my phone, I am storing its potential energy because gravity is pulling it down, but it can't go down because I'm holding it up. But that potential energy gets released when I drop the thing. So gravity batteries work by lifting something super heavy to create as much potential energy as possible. Then, when you need to use that stored power, bombs away! Now, obviously, it's not that simple. I can't just keep dropping my phone over and over to charge my phone. We need to get a little creative with our engineering to be able to harness the energy released when the thing drops. This solution is also really simple because we can use one device as both a motor and a generator at the same time. A motor and a generator are actually like the same thing, but in reverse of each other. Motors turn electrical energy into mechanical energy to make a thing spin, and generators turn movement into electrical energy. So with some clever engineering, you can use one device to do both. During times of excess energy generation, like when you're in California and all the solar panels are just throwing out free electrons, motor mode would push the heavy stuff up high where it has more potential energy. And then when they need it, they can switch to generator mode and release all that stored potential energy as kinetic energy to make the generator go. The coolest part is that we are actually already using gravity batteries, and have been for quite some time, in the form of pumped storage hydro power. All you do is connect two reservoirs, where one is up higher than the other. Water gets pumped up to that higher one while lots of energy is being produced, and then released to turn the generator when there's not as much energy flowing. Most gravity batteries are still squarely in the development phase, but pumped storage hydropower is already flowing here in the US. There are some downsides to pumped storage hydropower. It can have environmental impacts, like disrupting migratory paths and removing access to or even destroying certain habitats. So there's a good reason to think about other designs for gravity battery systems.
Thanks to Policy Genius for supporting this SciShow video. They help you make life insurance decisions that work for you, answer all your questions about the process, and even handle your paperwork. A lot of us find ourselves putting off things like life insurance, but with Policy Genius helping you through every step of the process, you can go ahead and get it done. And you'll do it for the right price. In just a few clicks, you can compare America's top insurers and find your most affordable option. With Policy Genius, you can find life insurance policies that start at just $292 per year for $1 million worth of coverage. Some options offer same-day approval and avoid unnecessary medical exams. So you don't have to keep putting off life insurance. You can make it easy with Policy Genius. Just head to policygenius.com/scishow or click the link in the description to get your free life insurance quotes and see how much you could save. That's policygenius.com/scishow.
Experts are playing around with all kinds of ways to make use of these potential energy machines. Turns out, there are a whole lot of ways you can design a system that just needs to lift and drop stuff over and over. Options include using abandoned mine shafts, the sides of mountains, or even the ocean. And then there are the delightfully weird ones, like there's an octopus-style crane that builds and unbuilds a tower, which never got made, maybe because of how the wind was going to affect those giant blocks of concrete on the end of tethers, or there's one that just drives a little train up a hill. I like that one. Now, all these technologies have their ups and downs. Get it? But when used at scale, they usually blow lithium-ion batteries out of the water in terms of cost, durability, and overall impact. Which finally brings us to skyscraper batteries. The architects that built the Burj Khalifa are teaming up with the people who designed the octopus crane battery to design a skyscraper that basically wraps around a gravity battery. The core of the building will contain something called a large-scale pumped hydro energy storage system. Concise, I know. Basically, they incorporated the existing tech for pumped storage hydropower into the walls and core of their building. It'll store water up in the higher floors and then release it to turn generators when energy is needed. Then, when there's plenty of energy, they can pump it back to the top and start the cycle over again. These battery skyscrapers could fit right into urban environments, which also means that you can generate electricity exactly where you need it, no electricity transportation required. There's no need for big holes, bulky dams, or cliff. The battery is just in the building. Plus, because it's in the middle of a city, there's no habitat disruption needed. I'm sure the fish will be thrilled. We're gonna need a whole lot of solutions to solve the climate crisis that we have gotten ourselves into. And some of those solutions are gonna be complicated, confusing, and difficult. So it's great that one of the biggest potential advances in energy storage is as easy as lifting something up and then dropping it. We definitely know how to do that.